Birds aren't real. So you haven't seen these clips yet. You've heard a little bit about it, but the story goes, birds are not real. They are from the CIA that has slowly been phasing out the real birds and then replacing them with drones because they're surveillance drones, right?
Okay.
They charge up on power lines, which is pretty clever. So you can
figured
buy a
it out.
T-shirt, right? You can get it on
I
the
am
movie.
A lie. I want that shirt. Really want that shirt.
Yeah.
And no one will even know you're talking about the birds. They'll just be like, what the fuck is a seagull doing on your shirt?
So what do bird truthers believe?
Every single bird in the sky is a robot. The United States government basically massacred 12 billion birds, beautiful living birds, using crop dusting airplanes flying over the states over the course of 40 years. And as the real birds died, the robotic drones rose. Now
See,
we live in a world
you.
Where there's 12 billion robotic birds watching us every single day.
Bird watching drones?
McIndoo kept up the act.
Did you see his little feminine dance?
Yeah. Feminine.
I haven't been able to figure out his type. I think he's some crazy EP.
That's pretty funny.
Can figure out his type in a minute.
I never hear anyone asking, hey, why don't our presidents talk? They tweet on the bird app with their left wing or right wing politics, you know? I think a lot starts to unfold and the matrix starts to shatter the more questions that you ask.
What bird is most suspicious to you?
Really every bird.
How do you feel about seagulls?
I don't trust them. I'll tell you that. Have you ever been to the beach and you got some food left over and a seagull comes over and tries to get it? That's not because it's hungry. You know, the mainstream media wants to sell us this lie that, oh, birds are hungry. You know, when in fact, the seagulls are taking your food to bring it back to the Pentagon for DNA harvesting and testing.
What's funny about this logic is I love like the left wing, right wing tweet. Like a good conspiracy, a good crazy story, whether it's a decider story, observer story, is based on little snippets of truth. Factual words, actual events. Like, wait, a seagull really did take my sandwich.
How do you feel about 60 Minutes? I'm surprised you've decided to sit here with us.
I'm not going to go on news shows, but shows about, you know, clocks and time, I'm okay with sharing my information with. And I understand this isn't anything like the media. So thanks for having me on your clock show.
With that, he finally broke character and we met the real Peter McIndoo.
You're the person that I've been hearing about but haven't seen.
Okay, great. Well, it was wonderful to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Welcome to Bird History.
McIndoo, the 24-year-old college dropout behind Birds Aren't Real, is fortunately nothing like the megaphone-carrying character under the cowboy hat.
Who will save us?
He told us it's all a parody. And it spread to billboards, bumper stickers, and popped up at halftime during the NCAA Men's Basketball National Championship game last month.
What's the purpose of all of this?
So it's taking this concept of misinformation and almost building a little safe space to come together within it and laugh at it rather than be scared by it and accept the lunacy of it all and be a bird truther for a moment in time when everything's so crazy.
I don't know what type this guy is. My guess would be my guess would be possibly an ESTP play last. Because like when he's in his play mode, it's like satanically crazy
right.
play mode. And then he's also being able to communicate. And I was like, I'm seeing a shit ton of N, but then I'm also seeing SE.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's an EP, if we can use that word, obviously.
Obviously.
So that's my best guess is he's some type of ESTP play
last.
That's
what I would have guessed. I would have guessed Elite SE. But what is fascinating is that he is like using what his type. I mean, Lead SE is one of the most intense types. It goes all in on the conspiracy shit because of the thing that we're talking about of SE this equals signs. It must conclude to this. And then their conclusions will be wild ass shit.
Yeah.
It'll be like fear of the Illuminati, fear of this random NI thing that's chasing me.
And it's not everybody like this kid, like a lot
I
of kids.
Love it.
They're like, yeah, I can see through that.
Right.
And so like, I guess what our story here is about the tool of trolling. Because this is Borat, Sacha Baron Cohen, you know,
oh,
like
yeah,
you
trolling.
Watch the Borat movies, you're like, these are really offensive and bad and I don't want my kids to see them. Until you realize, like when we watched videos of Sacha Baron, you know, Sacha Borat Cohen, where it's like, he's like a brilliant guy who's doing that on purpose where he's like, I see that my enemy or my opponent is so ridiculous.
Yes.
And I'm tired of arguing with them and going on the forums and trying to debate because they just get more insane.
Right.
I'm going to just take on their role, crank up the absurdity to make them look ridiculous.
The vision was creating something that reflected the absurdity through the eyes of the most confused archetype.
People, when they make fun of me, don't realize people also made fun of the founding fathers, you know, before they stormed the British gates and took over.
The humor is meant to be apolitical. McIndoo's co-conspirators, Claire Cronus, Cameron Caskey, and Connor Gatos, say it's become an outlet for a generation that's been surrounded by conspiracy theories.
It's an opportunity for, I think, our generation to laugh, to make fun, to kind of be like, look, here's like a laundry list of things that haven't come true.
You've been lying to us, so we're going to lie to you back, and we're going to do it in a way that really is funny.
What's interesting is like you look at this crew and they seem like a very intelligent group of young people.
The amount that someone comes at you with crazy, you're like, okay, Think about every version of an email that you could possibly say back that is respectful, that is real, where you're like engaging what they're saying. And if they're literally saying stupid, crazy shit, like the Illuminati and birds are not real and you guys are mind controlling it. Like, what are you going to ever say that would ever be able
to just
go
along with it? And the thing with trolling is that it is still messy. It still doesn't solve anything. It still causes problems, but you're literally talking about going to battle. So it's like, okay, so do I kick somebody or punch somebody? It's like, first of all, it's like, could you avoid the fight?
That's
your plan A. Anyways, when you're in a shit mess and the other group keeps coming after you and they won't back down.
That's where you have to have trolling.
This is just a tool to put in your arsenal.
McAdoo says more than a million people now call themselves bird truthers. They flock to rallies around the country. In front of Twitter's headquarters, they demanded the company drop its bird logo. And in St. Louis, McAdoo brazenly burned a Cardinals flag in the shadow of the arch. In an age of outrage, Peter McAdoo is hoping to drown out the chorus of crazy in this country with a little crazy of his own.
I fully support this message. I want to buy that t-shirt. One thing with type is like, from watching Jeff Bezos, this explosive out of control play energy.
I have seen that.
Getting off the fucking, you know, the rocket ship. He's just in a cowboy hat, just going fucking nuts.
I've seen him riding around on kids' toys and shit.
Yeah, just laughing hysterically.
Yeah, like when they do the play, it's in a very immature way.
Yeah.
So, I know it's me with Blast. Once I get turned on Blast, it feels like a baby rattler, like, the question I have, not that this matters, but like, how many of the people that he's riling up know that it's troll, that's a trolling message? Or are they all like,
he said in the interview that like he'll go up to groups and be like, hey, so you know birds aren't real. He's in his act.
Yeah.
And people will like instantly take over the conversation, like, oh yeah, I know the government's been watching us, blah blah, and they'll just start spewing on with their conspiracies.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh yeah, I totally know that birds aren't real. I totally know that birds are a part of a surveillance system. And they just like keep mumbling on. And he's just like, holy shit, this is even fucking worse than I thought. Because like people are just walking around with their loaded stories. Like, because if you're literally thinking like the New World Order, the government's out to get you, the world's gonna end, and then throw in that birds are surveillance units, like that's not the biggest deal to you because you're processing so much overwhelming crazy shit.
Yeah.
This isn't a big deal, but to the app, you know, like a double observer, they're like, wait a minute, that was really weird.
Yeah, you went too far.
Yeah.
Okay, so if he has a bunch of these, so here's what would go bad, and this is where I do see the SEs mess up, is he's like, boy, you're going way far. You're burning, burning shit, and you're going in front of actual Twitter and saying you should change your logo. Like,
right.
That's where I see that the SEs will get themselves fucked up because they're like, what? I thought it was a good idea at the time. You're like, maybe.
Right. What is the NI chess move of you just did this at a city in front of Twitter? Like, don't you think?
Don't you know what's coming next? Like, that is what I'm like. Oh, you're so fucked because this doesn't. Who's going to control this? Who eventually controls this? And then next, we burned the building.
I know.
What? It was in satire.
Right. This is definitely society's problem at this point.